time to say goodbye. Is this going to get us a copyright strike?
VidIQ.
VidIQ.
VidIQ.com.
On any YouTube page, click on your profile icon in the top right-hand corner of the screen and select Settings. From this page, down the left-hand side, click on Advanced Settings. Now this is where things start to get a little scary. At the bottom of this screen is a Delete Channel button. Don't worry, if you click this button, nothing happens just yet, as you will first need to provide your password. Once you do that, then you will be on the big decision-making screens. Let's start with permanently deleting your channel first. This will delete your videos, the users subscribed to your channel, all forms of engagement, your subscription to other channels, and your search and watch history. And this is an important distinction to remember. It removes not only the videos you have created, but your preferences as a video viewer. If you feel that this is a step too far, then consider the hide channel option instead. This will make private your channel, likes, users subscribed to your channel, and your subscriptions to other channels. What it will also do is permanently delete comments you've posted, but it will not delete your search and watch history. You will be asked to tick all of the checkboxes to confirm you understand what will happen to your channel. This option, however, does allow you to re-enable your channel at any time. When your channel is hidden from public view, you may see the message your YouTube channel has content but is disabled on your YouTube Video Manager page.
There are two obvious questions coming out of this tutorial. Have you deleted a YouTube channel, or have you considered deleting your YouTube channel? Do let us know in the comments below. If you do want to quit YouTube, here's my personal advice. Think really, really hard before you click that button. If you're finding the whole process too frustrating, if you think YouTube is against you, or you're simply burnt out, there is nothing wrong with taking a break. Many video creators do this. I have struggled with the pressures of YouTube in the past. I took an entire year off when I moved to a different country. But when I came back, I had a new fire lit within me, and now I do this. So even if you think YouTube is not the right fit for you right now, things can and will change. And if you do decide to carry on with your YouTube venture, then don't forget that vidIQ is here to help. We have a Chrome extension that will allow you to research YouTube, analyze videos, audit your own channel, and take actionable steps. There is a link in the video description. It is free to download. For more YouTube beginners guides, make sure to check out the playlist over here. For more awesome vidIQ content and tips and tricks on how to grow your channel, check out the link down here. We'll see you on either of those videos right now. Enjoy the rest of your video making day.